returned it ever. Community thing that he did, and they really don't need to see that.
They don't need to see that Jesus Christ is the
Son of
God.
Well, they do. They do in our church.
They do.
I guarantee you they do.
I am the church. I'm a lively stone.
Well, I am too. I've been a follower of the Lord Jesus Christ longer than you've been alive. But I guarantee...
Okay, let's stop right now. We need to pay close attention to what this man is about to say right now.
And I've taught Sunday school, 5th and 6th grade boys Sunday school for 35 years. I know, brother.
I'm evangelizing.
Saying, but I know, but these are little kids and they don't need to...
Jesus said stuff to the little children to come unto me.
Yeah, but he didn't preach to them. He brought them in and loved them. That's what Christ...
Let's stop right there and think about this. What is this man trying to say? He's saying that Jesus did not preach to them. He loved them. So therefore, we can conclude that this man, this pastor, is telling us that preaching is not love. Okay? So this man is insinuating that preaching is not loving. Okay. So let's keep going.
Well...
He says, faithful are the wounds of a friend.
Yeah, I know. And I can't stop you from walking on the road. I just wish you were more sensitive.
I am sensitive to the Holy Spirit. The Spirit said, go ye into all the world.
Yeah.
He said, despise the Holy Spirit. Jesus said these words, right? Unto all the world, preach the gospel to all creatures.
Yeah.
Well, some of these people are dressed up like creatures. We're going to preach to the creatures.
Well, that's... Yeah. What's the gospel?
The gospel is that Jesus Christ died for our sins and rose again for our justification.
Because what?
Because all are born... It's because we are born, sinners according to Psalms chapter 51. It says, behold, I was shapen in iniquity and in sin did my mother conceive me. We're born with a sinful nature. It says that when we're drawn away by the lust of our own heart, we're tempted when we're drawn away by the lust of our own heart. And Jesus said this, he says, from within, out of the heart of men proceed evil thoughts, wickedness, murders, adulteries, fornication. 22 says thefts, covetousness, deceit, lying, and all these things come from within and defile a man. So we're defiled. So we're here to give them the garment of praise. We're here to give them the garment of worship. We're here to talk to them about the word of God.
That doesn't look like the garment of worship.
That says Jesus Christ is the Son of God.
Oh, okay, I like that.
Jesus Christ is the Son of God. That says Malachi 4:1, the day that comes shall burn as an oven. All proud and all evildoers shall be stubble. The day that comes shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts.
Amen.
The judgment day is coming.
Amen.
Judgment day is coming. So we're preaching the severity of God as well as the grace of God.
Amen.
Preach the judgments of Jesus Christ as well as the mercy of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
This is the point where we've established a difference between my view of the scriptures and this pastor's view of the scriptures. You see, this pastor believes that biblical evangelism should not include an acknowledgement of the sinfulness of man or of the nature of man. Whereas we're going out here, we're preaching the severity, the full counsel of God is the solution, which is the gospel, is Jesus Christ, his atonement for our sins. But we also preach the problem, which is our sin, which is our deeds, which is our judgment that we rightfully deserve. So that's where we're parting now, and this is where we're going
to
get in.
And these little kids don't need to be preached.
These children do need to be preached to because it says when you raise a child when he is young, he shall not depart from that.
Yeah.
So we plant seeds, let God give the, growth, but let them both rejoice, sir. You're teaching in the church, and God bless you for teaching your Sunday school, but I'm evangelizing. If I'm planting seeds or scattering seeds or watering seeds, and you're seeing the increase, you're reaping, let us both rejoice together. Why should we be enemies? Have I become your enemy because I'm
you're not my enemy.
Amen.
I love it.
Amen.
I love you too, brother.
Christ died for me when I was still
sinner. This is the ministry that God has ordained me. God has ordained me and made me a minister.
Our message
by the will of
to
God
these kids
to
and these parents
these children today.
Is that God loves them, that Christ loves them, and we love them. Because the greatest commandment
is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your mind, all your strength. The second is just like it. To love your neighbor as yourself. And if you can't love your neighbors, then how can you say you love God who you have not seen?
Well,
so we're here loving the neighbors.
This is what I tell my kids. If you don't know how much God loves you, it's pretty hard for you to love somebody else.
Yeah.
It's when the realization of how much God loves you, me, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
He cried for our sins, right? It says that, according to this, it says in Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death, so that we should all pay. We have to pay for our sin. That is death. But Jesus says this. He says that the gift of God is a gift, a free gift. And we're here to spread that free gift and to share that grace to everybody. We're preaching grace. We're not preaching words. We're not preaching that these people have to do this and do that. We are preaching. No, this is the law. It says it also according to Romans 3:19. Yeah. It says, whatsoever the law saith, it saith to them that are under the law. Are you under the law of sin? Yes, we are under the law of sin. And it says that whatsoever says that every mouth may be stopped and all become guilty before God. We're here to bring sinners guilty before a holy God so they may be pardoned according to the grace that is in Jesus Christ, our Savior. So we have contrast, my friend. We have to have contrast. We can't just preach that Jesus died universally, giving a universal atonement for all. Yeah. God loved the world. All have an opportunity to come to God. Yeah. It's by their freely given the seed. That's their choice to receive it.
I mean, I wish I had time to fellowship with you because I love what you're saying, bro. But it's breaking my heart and a lot of people's hearts that their kids have to listen to. I wish you really.
It is breaking my heart that there is a schism in the body right now. This is the schism between the exaltation of the pulpit. When we exalt the pulpit preacher to such a level that the first are not last, the last are not first, that the position of being a minister is above the position of being a servant and being a witness. When we exalt these positions, you see, that breaks my heart. That breaks my heart to see a schism in the body, because according to 1 John 3:14, it says that we know we've passed from death unto life because we love the brethren. And whosoever doesn't love his brother abideth in death. And we love the brotherhood. We love the brethren. But this schism should not be, brothers and sisters. This schism between the pulpit preaching and the street preacher should not be.
Well, I really wish that their hearts were not broken, but the Bible says that whoever is born of God overcomes the world.
We go downtown to some adults.
We do go downtown as well. Believe me, brother. Well, we're not here to boast or talk about where we go.
Yeah.
Okay, we're here to talk to these people today. There's many years. We're here to love them with the word of God and the gospel of Jesus Christ. Before we have any more strife, I don't want to keep disagreeing with you, brother, but I have to preach the word of God to them, okay?
Well,
okay.
I'm just saying,
it's a reflection on our church.
God is ordained the EBI.
So that's where we had to leave off, brothers and sisters. I pray that we're able to learn from this, and maybe that we could also just take a time to really pray for the unity in the body. There's a major schism right now between evangelism, the evangelists, the street preachers, and the church. You know, when we look at the history of the church, I mean, throughout the ages, John Wesley was a street preacher. We look at the book of Acts of the Apostles, these men who went out, you know, they preached in the marketplaces. Acts 17, Paul was preaching in the marketplaces, in the synagogues. He even preached in Athens, you know, on Mars Hill. We see Jesus in the Sermon on the Mount. That was a mount. That was an open-air ministry. Even we see these things happening historically and biblically, but we see now that we're in the age of the pulpit, and it's not that the pulpit is wrong. It's not that we should not be gathering together. That is there's a time and a place to do so. But what I'm saying is that we need to also soften our hearts and be willing to give grace to these other ministries and these other parts of the body. There should be no schism in the body like this, brothers and sisters. And I hoped only to share this, not to condemn this pastor or put down this denomination, but just merely to show you that we should have more unity in Christ. Amen.
You're telling them they're going to burn. Hey, brother, it's a reflection on you.